By the way, hate to bring this up, but you may have gotten your W-2 form in the mail.
And that means it's time to prepare for tax day. Is it that time of the year again already? CBSMoneyWatch.com's Jill Schlesinger joins us with some important tips. So let's get started at the very beginning. What should we do now?
Well, first, let me just say that last week I told you and scared you about audits. Today, we're all about the prep. And Uncle Sam has a special present for you this year. 2 extra days to file. Taxpayers will have until Tuesday, April 17th, to file their returns. That's because April 15th falls on a Sunday, and Emancipation Day, a weirdo, esoteric D.C. holiday, falls on Monday, April 16th. So to start with your prep, here we go. Pay attention and open your mail. As these guys just said, your W-2s and 1099s should be rolling in right about now. In the meantime, you should also gather your credit card summaries and review your checking account. You're looking for deductions, charitable donations, job search costs. Don't forget, those are deductible. And I always use my previous year's return as a guide to what's missing.
That's a good idea. Mm-hmm. I didn't even think of that. Didn't we get a couple extra days last year?
Yes, we did. Well? Thank goodness for Emancipation Day.
I'll send
your card.
Is it ever better to wait to file?
Well, you know, the deal is, it's better to get all of your prep done as quickly as possible, but if you're due a refund, go ahead and file and get your money. If you owe money, there's really no benefit in sending Uncle Sam his money early. Now, to help you with your tax prep on MoneyWatch.com, we've done a quick analysis for you, the 3 best tax prep and filing programs. There's lots of choices now. Competition's heating up, so we'll tell you the best ones to use.
All right, maybe making it a little easier for everyone.
Why not?
All right, Jill, great to see you. Thanks so much.